everybody. It is Christmas Day, and we would love to wish you a wonderful Christmas from myself, Rags, and everyone here at Relax My Cat. We hope you're having a marvellous day. So we do have a video for you, even though it's Christmas Day. So Rexy and I have three top Christmas tree safety tips, but also Rags is going to be opening her Christmas stocking. First of all, with your tree, you need to make sure that it's safe and stable. If you have a Christmas tree that is on the floor, make sure that the stand that it's on is childproof. So if it's childproof, it's most likely catproof as well. Just make sure that it's high quality, that it is done up properly and can't be tinkered with by other children or cats. This just makes sure that it doesn't fall on you or your cat. Next, tinsel is actually a bit of a risk for cats. Now, Rags loves sitting on tinsel, I'm not sure why, maybe it's warm, I don't know. But you need to keep an eye on your cat if there is tinsel around. Now, some cats can be quite chewy and quite nibbly and might think that this is something to have a good old chew at, but if your cat ingests tinsel, not only can this cause obstructions and blockages in your cat's system, it's also not food, so your cat shouldn't be eating it. Not only that, but because it's like a string, it can get into your cat's body and cause all sorts of trouble. So it's just best, if you have to have tinsel on your tree, make sure it's like maybe on the upper half of the tree, away from where your cat can get to. And finally, if you have a real tree, just make sure that you are keeping on top of sweeping up the loose pine needles, especially after Christmas when your tree is getting a little bit older, the needles tend to fall off. You just need to make sure that your cat isn't going around either getting them stuck in their paw pads or eating them. So just be vigilant. This is Rexy's Christmas stocking. Now, if you've been a fan of Relax My Cat for a while, you will recognise this as the Christmas DIY stocking that we made a tutorial for last year. So if you want to make your cat one of these, just head on over to our video from last year. You can just search it in the search bar on YouTube and it'll come up with this tutorial. It's really fun to make and Rexy has had it on the tree ever since. Now, what is in your stocking, Rexy? Well, this looks really fun, whatever this is. It's a little toy! Now, Rexy isn't like the biggest fan of like these kinds of toys, but I know for a fact if I spray some catnip spray on this, she's gonna go crazy. What else do we have? Ooh, a packet of something. What are these? Catnip drops! She likes looking at them. Catnip drops, yay! Gonna give them here a little bit of a try. Oh, she's a fan. I will try and get some video of Rexy playing with these toys because she does like these little toys. And, ooh, Rexy, got a catnip one. Look, it's actually made of catnip. Look it. But it's actually made of catnip. How cute is that? Rexy. She loves it. Oh, good girl. Now, if you want to get your hands on any of these things, especially the catnip mice, I actually got them from Pets at Home, which is a big sort of pet department store over here in the UK. So if you want to get yourself, well, your cat, some super extra nice Christmas gifts. It's the catnip drop she dropped before. If you did enjoy the video, guys, please give us a big thumbs up. It helps us out loads. And if you've not subscribed already, just hit the button in the middle there to give us a subscription. And again, like I said, if you want to give the video from last week a little bit of love, just head on over to the other side of the screen. Thanks again for watching. Rexy and I hope you have a wonderful Christmas and we will see you in the new year. Bye!